Hello everyone, welcome back to another Adobe Photoshop CC 2018 tutorial. This one, I'm going to show you how to do a extremely realistic highlighter look. Guys, work with me here. Let's get right into this. If you're following along, you just want to go to File, New, like I have here, and just create an item. I'm going to go with 1920 by 1080, which is like YouTube approved thumbnail style, and I'm going to click Create. Off we go, we're on our way. The second step here is I am going to add in some type. So I'm just gonna left click on the horizontal type tool, and I'm gonna type something in. This is highlighted text, something like that, okay? No biggie. And now I'm just gonna center that here somewhere, right about, yeah, right there, let's go with that. Okay, now actually, you know what? Let's make it a little more realistic. Let's move it up higher. And let's say this is like a heading to something that you're writing and you want to highlight this. Okay, perfect. Now, the next step, guys, is we want to go ahead and start highlighting. We're going to go ahead and add in some brush work. So over here, you want to hit B for brush tool, or alternatively, you just click on it, and we're going to load up the brush tool. Now, when you do that, the next step is you want to go to Window and go to Brush Settings. If you're using an older version, it will say brush panel or something like that. But if you're in the new version, brush settings. Either way, they're very, very similar. So let's just go in and click on that. There is a difference, though. The new version has something called smoothing, which we'll talk about in a future video. But anyways, the next step here is you want to just basically take this hard round 32. It'll show up for everybody. It's one of the default brushes. Click on that. And you're going to see here, you've got this nice little circle brush down here. This isn't exactly what we want. So we're going to go ahead and increase the size of it to say 60 pixels. Let's start with that and we'll see how that goes. That's not the most important thing. The most important thing here is the angle and the roundness. Now for roundness, a highlighter is not a circle in most cases. So it's actually more like a 20%. It's very thin, and the angle is not sideways like this. We want to basically make it sort of, up and down slanty. So let's go with like 77%. And now you're going to see here that this is kind of what the highlighter looks like. And that looks pretty similar to what a highlighter tip would look like, including both the angle and the roundness. The next step here is you want the hardness to go up to 100%. And for spacing, we don't want to deal with too much of that. So we want to drop that down to like, let's go with 9%. It's not a real big deal, but it matters. So now we've created a brush that looks like basically the tip of a highlighter. We are on our way. I've also got layer one here, and I'm going to actually just skip off that, and I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer because I don't want to make too much of a mess. So on this new layer, we're now going to apply the brush to it, and we're going to go ahead and start creating some highlighter strokes. You're going to notice here that the brush isn't quite big enough for the text in this situation, so I'm going to increase the size of it by clicking on the right bracket key. Let's see what that looks like. That looks like about the right size for a highlighter, don't you say? Again, this is totally different depending on the size font you're using, but basically you just want the brush to be a little bit bigger than the text. For demonstration purposes, it's this size. So the next step here is on the new layer, I'm going to hold down the shift key to make sure that it goes across straight, and I'm just going to drag right. Now, you're going to notice here that this isn't exactly correct unless you're using a gray highlighter, which would be strange. So I'm going to Command or Control Z that. Command or Control Z is the undo button, and I'm going to do it again, but this time, instead of the foreground color to black, which is wrong, I'm going to use yellow. Let's go with bright yellow. Also, this is very, very important. The flow's at 100%, smoothing's at 10%, but I've got a reduced opacity of about 35% as well. Again, color that to your taste, but in this case, for highlighter, it works pretty good. So let's shift, left shift, and I'm going to go across like this. Boom. That text is highlighted. It's still not perfect, and I'm going to go ahead and highlight back like I would normally do. I'd go left to right, right to left. And back we go, and there we go. We've got two layers of highlight. Now notice something here while I got you. They applied on top of each other, and the reason why is that this here is set to multiply. If it's set to normal, which is the default, it doesn't work as good because they don't interact with each other. The two layers, the two highlights won't work on top. They'll just be one highlight. So again, you want to go with multiply and then boom, we've got sort of highlighted text here. I'm also going to go ahead and maybe make another little bit here on the left side. So I'm going to make that a little darker because that's kind of how I would highlight because I got friggin' monkey hands, and then maybe a little bit out here, and then maybe, well, no, Command Z, Control Z, maybe I would be a little bit messy or something like that. Okay, I don't know. I don't know what kind of highlighter you guys have. I'm pretty bad at it, so not gonna lie. But there we go. We've got some really badly highlighted text, but this is for demonstration purposes only. I'm not very good at highlighting, but we want to make some more changes. The next change here, guys, is we're gonna make sure you're on layer, whatever your layer is. I'm gonna delete that layer because it was a mistake. So on your first layer that you created, and I'll rename this to layer one because that's what it will say in your panel. But because I got monkey hands, oops, I had two layers. You're going to want to go now and change this blend mode to multiply as well. The reason why is that's going to make the dark black text, it's going to pop out a little bit more. I'm going to add a little bit more highlight in there and maybe a little more there because I got monkey fingers. But anyways, that's what the highlight looks. This might be good enough for what you're looking for, but there is another step we can go one step further, because when you highlight, you generally smudge the ink a little bit. It's very, very subtle. It's very nuanced, but you do sometimes make a little bit of a smudge because the ink is dry or because the highlighter moves the ink a little bit outside. So let's go ahead and do that as well. To do that, you want to go back to your original highlighted text, just like this. So we're working on the text layer, as I'll turn on and off, you'll see it. And now you want to go, instead of the brush tool, you want to go to this very rarely used smudge tool. That's right, guys, we're pulling out the smudge. Let's do this. All right, so I'm over here on that little pointy finger, and we are using the smudge tool. Now, when I click on this layer, you're going to notice here that the layer must be rasterized. So we're going to go ahead and proceed with that and rasterize that bad boy. Now, the next step, and you'll see here, is the strength of the smudge tool. It's usually default set to like 50%. If you have it at that, it's going to make a whole world a mess, and you're not going to like it. So I'm going to go ahead and reduce the strength from 50% to like 3%, because this is a pretty delicate, nuanced thing. So now I'm going to go ahead and start applying some smudge, and you'll see some very big little bit of smudge. It's very, very subtle, not going to lie, but I am smudging the text a little. And this gives the impression that the text is kind of moved, it's kind of bled out a little bit, you know, it's not perfect, but it's very, very close. And if I go ahead and take it off, take it on, you're going to see if you look really, really close, there is some very, very simple smudging. And this gives a very, very good highlighted appearance. Guys, this ain't perfect, but it's pretty good. And the reason why it isn't perfect because I can't highlight in a straight line and I overdid it. But that's how you create a highlighted text inside Adobe Photoshop CC 2018. If you have anything you want to see, let me know. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'll be back more with some more stuff shortly. Thanks for watching.